Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you.
Thank the Lord. I believe the Lord is trying to tell us tonight that we need to pray some more.
Amen.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Tonight's going to be maybe a little bit different. Amen. Praise God. I want to leave a little bit different than what I came in.
Yes, sir.
A little more determined.
All right, sir.
A little more expectant.
All right, man.
That God to do some things in our lives. Praise God.
Yes, sir.
Amen. The Lord has not changed.
No.
Think about it.
Amen.
One of the great qualities of God is that in Him there is no variableness, neither shadow of turning.
Amen.
That the Lord is steadfast in all of His ways.
Yes.
That He is the same yesterday, today, forever.
Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
He's set. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. So it's not the Lord that drifts. It's not the Lord that changes.
No.
It's us.
Yeah.
Praise God. Amen. And so I'm just going to preach just for a little bit. Amen. Then we're going to have a prayer meeting.
Awesome.
Praise God.
Awesome.
And the Holy Ghost is going to move.
Yes, sir.
Every now and then, it doesn't happen very often. Now, we don't want to mislead you into thinking that I have these great visions all the time. But every now and then, the Lord will show me how the service is supposed to end. I'll see the end of the service, and I don't have a clue how we're going to get there.
All right. That's good.
Just being honest. I don't have any idea how we're going to get there. But I will not be satisfied until we get there.
All right. All
praise
right.
God.
Come on.
And if you and I tonight will be sensitive to the voice of God, sensitive to the Spirit of the Lord, then we will respond accordingly to what the Lord wants to do in this service tonight. Amen. We will leave a better person.
Yes, sir.
A better Christian.
Right.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. It is the will of God, the absolute will of God, for you and I to find God in everything we do.
Yes, it is, sir. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
That we discover the presence of God in everything we do.
Amen.
For in Him,
yes.
In Him,
in Him,
we live, and move, and dwell, and have our being. Praise God. That we walk in His presence.
Right.
As many as are led by the Spirit of God,
they are
the sons of God. In this keen awareness of God's presence in our life, in all of our activities. And if you're doing something where you can't feel the presence of God and you know God is not pleased with what you're doing, then you need to change.
Yes, sir.
Praise God.
Amen.
Can you say amen?
Yes, amen.
In Acts chapter 3, if you would like to turn there, I'm going to read just a few scriptures and then we're going to take a little journey, amen, through the book of Acts. Amen, just for a moment. Amen, then I'm going to ask you to make some commitments.
All right.
Praise God. I'm going to ask me to make some commitments.
Yes.
While I'm preaching. Hallelujah. The Bible said in Acts chapter 3, verse 1, now Peter and John went up together into the temple at the hour of prayer. It was a set time.
All right.
A purposed time.
Amen.
At the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour. And a certain man lame from his mother's womb was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that entered into the temple. Who, seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked an alms. And Peter, fastening his eyes upon him with John, said, Look on us. And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. Then Peter said, Silver and gold have I none.
All right.
But such as I have, give I thee.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth,
rise
up and walk.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah.
And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up. Excuse me. And immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. And he leaping up stood and walked and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. And all the people saw him walking and praising God. Notice verse 10. And when they knew that it was he which was set for alms at the beautiful gate of the temple, and they were filled with wonder and amazement at that which had happened unto him. Praise God.
Amen.
And this stirred up a lot of emotions among the people.
Yes, it did.
For a lot of the people, they were amazed and they were excited and they were glad. And they thought Peter and John to be some kind of gods.
Oh, yeah.
And they ran to them, the Bible said. And when Peter saw it, he answered, verse 12, unto the people, You men of Israel, why marvel you at this? Or one look you so earnestly on us as though by our own power or holiness we had made this man whole or to walk. And then it begins to preach to them about the God of Abraham and Isaac and Jacob. Amen. It began to minister to them. Then verse 16 said, In his name, through faith in his name, hath made this man strong, whom you see and know, yea, the faith which is by him hath given him that this perfect soundness in the presence of you all. Praise God. Amen. I want to preach just for just a few moments. Committed to a greater cause.
All right.
Committed to a greater cause.
All right.
Praise God. Father, we love you. We thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for the privilege, the honor of being in your house. Thank you for the privilege of ministering, Lord, to these wonderful saints. God, I thank you to bless, Lord, the pastor, Pastor Black, pastor's family. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us feel the angels of the Lord in this house.
We praise you. We magnify you, O God.
Let us feel, Lord, the angels of God in this city. In the name of Jesus Christ.
My God, in Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, dear God. We praise you.
Praise God.
Amen.
God bless you. Would you clap your hands unto the Lord? Amen. God bless you. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. This wonderful passage of scripture, amen, that we read, amen, about this lame man, praise God, who had been lame for 40 years.
All right.
Amen. It wasn't that he was like some in an accident, amen, as would happen in our time, amen, a car accident, what have you, motorcycle accident, amen, and because of the injuries could not walk. This man simply never walked.
Right, right.
Amen. And so being in that condition, amen, he never developed any leg muscles. He never had any strength in his lower body until somebody had enough faith on the way to prayer. On the way to prayer.
All right.
To pray.
Yeah. Yeah.
Praise God.
Yeah.
On the way to prayer, they stopped long enough
to pray.
To pray.
Amen. Hallelujah.
The Bible would instruct us to be instant in season and out of season.
Yes, sir.
The Bible would instruct us to be ready, to be prepared.
Amen.
Amen. In all times. Amen. And I have mentioned this before, but one day the Lord told me to be ready to pray anywhere.
All right.
Praise God. And so when the Lord impressed me to be ready, amen, to pray anywhere, which the Lord was saying, it doesn't matter if it's a restaurant, doesn't matter if it's a laundromat, doesn't matter if it's a grocery store, doesn't matter where you are, amen, whether the need that presents itself and somebody needs prayer, then I want you to pray. Praise God and pray for them right then. Praise God. And, and see, prayer, amen, our responsibility, I got a little irritation in my throat. Amen. Prayer is our responsibility. The results of our prayer are God's responsibility.
Yeah.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Let me say that again. Our responsibility is to pray.
Right.
It's God's responsibility to react to our prayer.
Right, yeah.
Amen. So we are afraid that if we pray, God will not answer.
Right.
We have this fear factor, amen. If I step out there and I go beyond myself, amen, and I try to exercise, amen, the prior power of prayer and the prior of faith in my life, amen, and they don't get healed and nothing happens, then I messed up. Amen. And because of that, amen, we don't step out by faith. Amen. Right. We reserve ourselves.
All
and we
right.
say, well, I will pray for you after a while. I'll pray for you when I get home. I'll pray for you at church.
No,
we need to say, I'll pray for you right now. Praise God. Now's the time. Amen. For prayer. We've got to believe that when we pray.
Come on. Yes, sir.
Amen. When we pray, amen, that God is going to respond, amen, to whatever we say. That God is going to respond. Amen. Silver and gold have I not. Amen. Too many times we as an individual and as a church collectively judge ourselves for what we don't have.
Right.
If I just had this or if I just had that.
Right.
If we just, as Pastor alluded to, if we just had a better program.
Come
on,
right.
Amen. If we had just better equipment, if we had better, a bigger van, if we just had a bigger bus, if we just had a bigger, if we had just better teachers, if we had just better whatever, amen, then we could have a move of God, then we could have revival.
Right.
Amen.
Come
then
on.
We could meet the need. If we just had more money,
come
more
on.
Finances, then we could have a move of God. Amen. Peter said, silver and gold I don't have. Amen. But you gotta understand, so I do have something.
All right, come on.
Amen. We need to look at ourselves, amen, and judge ourselves by what we don't have, not by what we don't have, but what we do have.
Amen.
Amen. What we do have is the power, amen, of the name of Jesus Christ. What we do have is the power of prayer, amen, to reach out by faith and take somebody by the hand, amen, and lift them up.
Yes, yes, hallelujah.
Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Rise up and walk.
Yes, sir. Come on. That's
amen. And immediately.
Boy,
I like that word.
Yeah. Yeah. Immediately.
Amen. Immediately his ankle bones received strength.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And he, leaping up, stood.
Yeah. Yes.
Again, remember, this man never felt the bottom of his feet in all his life.
Right.
He's never felt his feet on terra firma.
Right.
He's always been in a prostrate position.
All right.
Amen. But when the Holy Ghost moved, when the Spirit of God moved, when the power of prayer is invoked, when the name of Jesus Christ is invoked, amen, and God sends forth a miracle, amen, this man leaping stood and walked, amen, praising God and went with Peter and John into the temple.
Hallelujah. Come on, that's good.
Praise God.
That's good stuff.
Amen. And this stirred up a lot of feelings.
Yeah,
among a lot of people. Some were amazed, some were thrilled, amen. Some were just beside themselves, amen. But then there was the religious crowd that wasn't so pleased.
Right.
Amen. Praise God because of this miracle. And so they pulled them aside and they commanded them, amen, not to preach or teach in the name of Jesus. Praise God. Verse 7 said, and when they had set them in the midst, they asked, by what power or by what name have you done this?
Amen.
Praise God. There's no other name.
Yeah. All right.
Come on.
Oh, come on, people.
Amen.
There's no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. There's no name like the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, come on, somebody. There's no name like the name of Jesus Christ. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, I'm looking forward to the day. I pray, I hope. Amen. I hope I get to see it. I hope we get to witness. Amen. The Bible said that the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that He is Lord to the glory of the Father. Amen. I believe, I hope to God, I get to witness. Amen. Muhammad, take a knee. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I pray I get to watch Satan himself bow a knee and say, you are Lord. Amen. I pray, oh, hallelujah. There's none other name under heaven given unto men whereby we must be saved. Amen. I want to preach to you tonight that we are taking on the name of Jesus in baptism. Amen, this wonderful privilege and this wonderful honor, right. Amen, of invoking the name of Jesus, amen, into the lives of our children, amen, to the lives of our family, amen, to take the name of Jesus and with authority apply that name, come on, to every situation in our life, amen, to every problem in our life, amen, to every difficulty in our life, amen, to every sickness in our life. In the name of Jesus
Christ.
Hallelujah.
Come on, that's good.
You remember verse 10, he said, be it known unto you all, to all the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him doth this man stand before you whole.
Oh,
amen. Hallelujah. This is the stone.
Yes, sir.
Which was set at naught by you builders, which has become the head of the corner. Neither is there salvation in any other. For there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved.
Hallelujah.
Notice verse 13. Now when they saw the boldness.
All right,
sir. Hallelujah. Oh, man, that's what we need, a good shot of boldness. Amen. We need a good dose of boldness. Amen. We need a good, good saturation of boldness in our spirit. When they saw the boldness of Peter and John, and perceived that they were unlearned and ignorant men, they marveled, and they took knowledge of them that they had been with Jesus.
Yes, they did. Hallelujah.
Come on.
Thank you.
If you've ever been with Jesus, you'll never be the same.
Yes.
Right. Can I get a witness?
Amen. Come on.
Amen. If you've ever had an encounter, amen, with Jesus Christ, as we have, our life will never remain the same. Praise God. Amen. They may look at us. Amen. We may look like a bunch of redneck hillbillies from the backwoods of Virginia. Amen. But friend of mine, you got to understand. Amen. We may be unlearned and ignorant according, amen, to the echelon. Amen. But to God Almighty, we are His children. We are His church. Amen. We are the apple of His eye. We have been bought with the price. Amen. We are the temple of God. Hallelujah.
Thank you,
amen. Praise God that we are, oh, come on, somebody. We're not part.